Time now to go inside out with SNY NBA insider Ian Begley. Jalen Brunson joining Julius Randle on the injury report Monday as both are now questionable for game two with bum ankles. Ian, I know you love it when I ask you to use your medical degree, but what's your gut telling you about their availability?
You know, Eamon, I was in residency at Four World Trade Center, that formidable hospital. So I know what I'm talking about here. And what I'm going to tell you about Jalen Brunson is the sore foot. I can't see it keeping him out of the lineup on Tuesday. And I say that because we saw him, you know, favoring one side, being a little bit compromised in game one, especially during stoppages of play. You saw him kind of limping just a touch, very slightly. But, you know, after the game, he looked okay. So unless he woke up Monday morning just really in pain with the soreness in the foot, I would assume he goes, and you know he's going to want to play because game two here, Knicks losing game one. You really have to get game two. He knows that. He's going to want to show up for his teammates.
All right, the Knicks were just 7 of 34 from behind the arc in game one. Was it just an off day, or do they have to make an adjustment now to get better looks?
They got a lot of good looks, I thought, especially second side of the floor, because Miami in the second half, they really packed the paint on defense. They left that shooter on the weak side of the floor with plenty of room to operate. So if they continue that, and they should because they had success with it, I would think the Knicks get the same looks that they got in game one. And look, this is not a strong three-point shooting team. You know, you look over the course of the year, not many sharpshooters, but these are open looks, and these are looks that the Knicks have knocked down at a pretty good rate during the season. So they should knock these shots down on Tuesday. They should get them again, and we'll see what happens. But a guy like Josh Hart starting lineup, I would think he will knock down a couple more than he did in game one because he really struggled.
All right, Ian, I know you just mentioned how critical game two is after losing game one at home. So do you subscribe to the theory that this is now a must-win game at the Garden for New York?
I do, and I say that because you're home. You can't drop both at home in a seven-game series, and only 7% of the, I think it was 400-plus teams to go down 0-2 in a seven-game NBA series ended up coming back. So odds are against you if you lose game two. Knicks need to get this one.
And we're looking forward to your report from MSG after game two on Tuesday. Dr. Begley, thanks for joining us here on Honda Sports Night.